Hey, and welcome back. This is volume number 10 in this series, and for this little milestone, I think we have one of my favorite episodes yet. On this show, I discuss a few songs that I love that, for whatever reason, I think you may not be familiar with. Lately, I'd like to think that the series has been getting into a pretty good groove of different genres, different levels of popularity, and so on. This episode is hopefully going to keep that trend going, and without further ado, this is Great Songs You Might Not Know. Up first, we're going to be talking about a song called The Seed by Cody ChesnuTT. This is an artist whose reputation knows no bounds. He's kind of hard to describe, but I think my best introduction of him would be saying that he's your favorite musician's favorite musician. He's somebody whose influence is much greater than his commercial sales. He's the type of guy that Nardwar would bring up in an interview with a much more famous musician, and then the musician would say, "How did you know I love Cody ChesnuTT?" So Cody is mainly an R&B soul musician, and he's from Atlanta, Georgia. However, as you might guess with the way that I've been describing him so far, he's not your average R&B soul musician. He's somebody who has been toying around with the idea of genre for his entire career, and it certainly feels wrong to categorize him as one thing and put him in a box. My favorite example of this is on Cody's debut album, The Headphone Masterpiece, which is just pure insanity. It's a double album that features almost 40 tracks and sits at around 2 hours long. As I keep giving you more and more clues, you're probably getting a better picture of who this guy is in your head. For me, when I found out that his first project was this long and it had the word masterpiece in the title, that certainly helps. When you look at some of the great boundary pushers of history, self-indulgent is a word that might come up, but you know, it is what it is, I guess. Anyways, this project is fantastic and I highly recommend it. There are elements of pop, R&B, neo-soul, hip-hop, rock, and so on. It was recorded in his bedroom, so there's a big lo-fi feel to all of it, and with this many tracks, the lyrical themes touch on a wide array of topics and emotions. I picked the track The Seed for this episode because I think it's a perfect transition song for getting into Cody's music and this big, possibly daunting album. It's very groovy, you clearly get a great blend of all the sounds that Cody loves, and the melodies on this thing are unreal. With any track featuring lo-fi production, I think that usually adds a level of charm and authenticity, and when we remember how grand this whole project is, I think that juxtaposition of lo-fi sounds and huge ideas is really, really fascinating. Through this song, you get the feeling of how bad he wants this, how much he needs to make music, but there's also a hint of knowing that he knows how talented he is. There's a lot of different emotions that go into this for me, and yeah, it's very fun. And I think it's a good transition song for getting into his stuff because The Roots eventually worked with him on a remix of sorts of this track that is much more finely tuned and they sound different, but not too different. I like both versions, but one was this weird genius mix of sounds produced in a bedroom, and the other was made by one of the most critically acclaimed bands of all time near the height of their success. I'm glad both exist, but the Roots version obviously wouldn't be here without Cody's. If Mary dropped a baby girl tonight, I would name her. Next up, I want to talk about the song Concrete by Poppy. This is the opening track off her new album, I Disagree, and I think it's the funniest thing in the world. This song sounds like a parody, and from my perspective, it is genius, but I want to give a tiny backstory here to really emphasize what's going on. Poppy is interesting, to say the least. She's a YouTuber turned musician, I guess, but she's the weirdest example of what I just described. Poppy is more of an art project than anything. Her YouTube videos would be these strange, deadpan, uncomfortable things where this woman is talking to the camera about mostly nothing, and nobody really has a good explanation of what Poppy was and why she was doing the things that she did. Sometimes her videos would only be a few seconds long, and sometimes they would be nearly an hour long. Sometimes it would be a fun video of her dancing with whatever this thing is, and sometimes they would feel sinister and creepy and evil. There's a 10-minute video of her just saying, "I'm Poppy," over and over again, which is a masterpiece. There's one called Poppy Eats a Meal, and it's just food disappearing on a plate. Doritos Monster Energy Drink is another classic, and I'm sure you get the gist by now. So Poppy is also a musician. She has dropped 3 albums, Poppy.computer, Am I a Girl, and her latest release, 2020's I Disagree. And just like all her videos, these albums are both funny and uncomfortable, but more than anything else, there is a one-of-a-kind energy with Poppy that I really don't think you'd be able to find anywhere else. Over time, her music has grown much more intense and dark. On Poppy.computer, there was a lot of super bright, super cute bubblegum pop, and now on I Disagree, there's a ton of heavy metal on here. I went with the track Concrete because it is the funniest best of both worlds combination between those two ideas, bubblegum pop and heavy metal, and I love it so much. I have never heard anything quite like this before. It's not uncommon for people to experiment with very different sounds over the course of an album, but the concept of having one song, your opening track, be a combination of two genres that are worlds apart is hilarious to me. It's weird, it's challenging, and while I would not recommend this to everybody, if you're willing to give it a try, I think you're gonna have some fun. And finally, I want to talk about the song Comic Sans by Audrey featuring Jack Harlow. This musician and this specific song were recently brought up on that Genius series where established rappers give out cosigns to up-and-coming rappers, and because this episode features Zach Fox and because of who he discusses, it is by far the best episode of that series ever. And with that being said, Audrey is hopefully going to blow up in 2020, and I think she could become one of the most exciting faces in rap. Her flows are crazy, her beat selection is top-notch, and her music videos are absolutely wild. To give you some background, Audrey is a young Korean-American rapper who is based out of New York. She was attending NYU's prestigious Clive Davis Music Institute, but she took a break to explore her music and truly devote herself to her art. While a Korean-American girl rapping is certainly not the norm in hip-hop, she's up for the challenge. Audrey has discussed that her entire life has been a series of people telling her who she should be, but she always goes her own way, and that's the same idea within her music. With this specific song, I think it's a perfect introduction to her stuff for many reasons. The beat is just a little bit weird, but it doesn't draw too much attention to itself. I'd say that Audrey's flows are her main appeal, and this instrumental lets her show off those flows in a great way. Like I mentioned, we get a Jack Harlow feature, so if you're already familiar with him and you're a fan, I think this is one big advantage of listening to hip-hop. Checking out what your favorite rappers are featured on or who they're featuring in their stuff is typically a cool way to find new music. The two musicians are probably gonna be on somewhat of a similar wave, and while Audrey is a bit more artsy, I think that's the case here. While she doesn't have a full project out right now, you should definitely check out all her other singles. She's exciting, she's a breath of fresh air in the rap game, and I can't wait to see what she does next. Be sure to check out all the songs and musicians that I mentioned, comment below with what you might want to see in a future episode, and thanks for watching. Hey, thank you for watching that video. If you want to support the channel, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. You can follow me on social media at RenshawHS. You can buy my merch, support my Patreon, and thank you again. I'll see you soon.